How many agents should you interview? And as you interview them, what are the top 5 questions that you should be asking? Hi, I'm Denise Fox with the Fox Team and RE/MAX, and that's what we're going to talk about today. How many agents should you be interviewing before you select one to list your home? The number's 3. That is the suggested amount. Definitely not less than 2, because you want to have some point of comparison. I cannot stress enough that we are not all created equal. Every single realtor, no matter what brokerage they're with, every single realtor is their own independent contractor. We are all responsible for our own marketing strategies. When I say we're not all created equal, I couldn't stress it more. So you want to be sure that you're selecting the right person that you feel you can work with. This is a very personal process and you're in it pretty deep with each other. So you need to make sure you feel comfortable working with that person, and you need to make sure they have the right level of experience and the right plan to get you the most amount of money in the least amount of time, and pain-free, of course. Number 1, how will you price my home based on its condition and location, and why? That's an important question. They shouldn't just come in and flip a number off. They should know the area well enough that they come prepared with comparable properties. These are like properties to yours, the same style home. You're not gonna compare a split level with a colonial, for instance. They're 2 different style homes. You're not gonna compare a 3-bedroom with a 5-bedroom. You need to have the same size, amenities, and style home. And they should be able to demonstrate that and know the area well enough that they come prepared, tour your home, and be able to see what you have in person, and then give you a number that makes sense. Number 2, what do you do in a multiple offer situation? If that agent quickly responds, well, we take the highest offer, that is not gonna be the agent you wanna choose. The package of the most favorable terms, you wanna hear from them that they know how to put those together side by side, go over them with you, present the benefits of each as well as the red flags of each so that you can actually pick the best offer that works best for you. The next is, what type of marketing strategy do they have that they can demonstrate to you? One easy question is, who's the name of your photographer? Who's the name of your stager? If they don't have one, they don't have the most basic part of a marketing plan. Where's your property going to be exposed? Do they have a digital marketing plan, a social media marketing plan? They need to have a structure that they can actually lay out and explain to you, not just a post being made somewhere on their regular page. There needs to be a strategy. If they say, we do professional photography, that often can just mean that that agent intends on doing the pictures themselves and they feel that they have a fancy enough camera. That's not gonna cut it. You need a professional photographer that knows the angles, has the lighting right, can offer different types of photography, such as drone photography, twilight photography. If you've got acres or a pool or a horse property, to not use drone photography would be a crime in that. So you wanna make sure you're asking that question. Number 4, how many listings do you sell in a year? Not just how many houses do you list, how many listings do you sell? In my mind, it should be like no less than 12. There are a lot of really, really good agents who are buyer's agents, and they are great at what they do. But listing a home requires a completely different skill set. And then number 5 would be, how often do you follow up? How often are you following up with the title company once we're under contract? How often are you following up with the buyer's lender? And how often are you checking in with me? This is very important. When I go take a listing over from somebody else who failed to sell it, I ask what went wrong. And the number 1 thing I get back is, they didn't ever communicate. We never knew what happened here. We never heard from them again. Communication is key. You want somebody who's going to be in it with you. Like I said earlier, this is a very personal process and you get real deep in it with each other. So you want someone who's going to communicate with you. I hope this helps. If you have any questions, you can always reach me at 301-367-8118. If you are out of the area, I can always refer agents out as well. So don't hesitate to reach out to me for that. Thanks for watching, and please click the like button if it was helpful.